Hello friends, welcome to Tech Learning YouTube channel. Today we will discuss about the various types of fires. The fires can be classified based on their types of combustible material or fuel involved in the fire. Friends, if you have not subscribed our channel, please subscribe right now and don't forget to press the bell icon. Thank you. What is fire? Fire can be easily understood by a fire triangle. A fire triangle is a simple way to understand the elements of fire. As you know, that a triangle has three sides. The individual side of the triangle represents the independent element of fire which are required to ignite a fire or to continue a fire. These three basic elements are: the first element is fuel, the second element is oxygen, and the third element is heat. In case of absence of any of these elements, fire will stop or it cannot be ignited anyhow. The elements of fire. Let us discuss each element of fire. The first and most essential element of fire is heat. Without heat, the fire is not possible. As we know, the heat is a source of ignition. A fire cannot ignite unless a certain amount of heat is present along with the other elements. So, if you want to extinguish a fire, just cool down its temperature and the fire will stop. The second element is fuel. Fuel of any fire is the material that burns with the fire. Fuel can be combustible materials like wood, paper, flammable liquids, or gases. The cutting the supply of fuel is the second method to extinguish a fire. So, if you cut the supply of fuel, fire will stop. The final and last element of fire is oxygen. The oxygen is also an essential element of fire. Without oxygen, fire cannot be ignited nor it can be continued. When fuel burns in presence of oxygen, it generates the heat. Heat further combusts the flammable substances. Without presence of heat, the fire also cannot ignite nor it can be continued. So, if we cut the supply of oxygen, fire will extinguish. The final and last element of fire is oxygen. The oxygen is also essential element of fire. Without oxygen, fire cannot be ignited nor it can continue. When fuel burns in presence of oxygen, it generates the heat. The heat further combusts the flammable substances. Without presence of heat, fire cannot start and nor it can be continued. So, if we want to stop the supply, we have to cut the supply of oxygen. The fire will stop in the absence of oxygen. Types of fire. There are various types of fire. The fires can be classified based on the types of combustible material or fuel involved in the fire. The different types of fire must be extinguished with a suitable fire extinguisher. In this video, we will discuss about the different types of fire and the types of fire extinguisher must be used to extinguish the particular type of fire. The fires can be classified in the following category: Class A fire, Class B fire, Class C fire, Class D fire, and the Class K fire. Class A fire. A Class A fire is the most common type of fire exist. A Class A fire involves the solid organic substances like wood, paper, textile, fabric, coal, and most of the plastic items as a fuel. The class A fire is the easiest fire to extinguish. However, it is recommended to use the water fire extinguisher and foam fire extinguisher on class A fire. Class B fire. The second type of fire we are going to discuss is class B fire. Class B fire involves ignitable liquids or gases like petroleum, greases, alcohol, paint, propane, gasoline, or as a fuel. The class B fire should be extinguished by a foam fire extinguisher, powder fire extinguisher, or carbon dioxide fire extinguisher. All of these fire extinguishers work by the cutting of the supply of oxygen element of the fire. Remember, the water fire extinguisher cannot be used on class B fire. Class C fire. Class C fires involve the fires due to faulty energized electrical equipment, electrical wirings, short circuits, overhead or overloaded electrical breakers or electrical panel or other electrical devices. The class C fire are very common in both homes and industrial premises. As long as the faulty equipment is connected to its power source, the power acts as a continuous source of ignition. Class C fire should be extinguished by the carbon dioxide fire extinguisher or dry powder fire extinguisher. Water fire extinguisher or foam fire extinguisher cannot be used to extinguish the class C fire because they are conductive to electrical current. If the electrical power source is disconnected, then this fire may be extinguished by a water or foam fire extinguisher. Class D fire. Class D fire is characterized by the presence of burning metals. A class D fire is unique and can lead to the most dangerous fire due to its unique features. Class D fire involves the ignite combustible metals such as potassium, magnesium, aluminium, and sodium. Because these metals can ignite when they are exposed to air or water. The best and only the recommended way to extinguish the class D fire is by using a dry chemical powder fire extinguisher. Come to the next type of fire, which is class K fire. A class K fire is a cooking fire which involves combustion from liquid used in food preparation. Cooking fires are caused by a wide range of liquid cooking materials, greases, cooking oils, vegetable fats, and animal fats are the fuel sources found in class K fire. Class K fire can be very dangerous. A wet chemical fire extinguisher must be used in putting out the type of class K fire. Friends, never use a water or water fire extinguisher to put out a class K fire. Class K fire. A class K fire is a cooking fire which involves combustion from liquids used in food preparation. Cooking fires are caused by a wide range of liquid cooking materials, grease, cooking oils, vegetable fats, and animal fats are the fuel sources found in class K fire. The class K fire can be very dangerous. A wet chemical fire extinguisher must be used in putting out the class K fire. Friends, never use a water or water fire extinguisher to try out a class K fire.